students, today we are going to see the economics, 10th standard economics first lesson, gross domestic product and its growth, an introduction. So definition of GDP. GDP means gross domestic product. The GDP is the market value of all the final goods, that is finished goods and service produced in the country during a time period. They are limiting the period, that is, so one the starting year March to and the next year April. So this is the economic year, and the final goods, the finished goods and services calculating in the country in this particular year, that is called the GDP, gross domestic product. And goods and service, so goods means we are producing goods, service means so teachers, lawyers, doctors, and the communicated peoples, these are called the service people. And we can touch and know the goods, but we can't touch the service. For example, a cup of tea is making, we can see, we can touch the cup, but the ingredients and in the service also we can't know that, we can't feel. And this is called the tangible items, we can't touch the product. So as you know by now, goods and service and tangible items, while service are actives which are intangible. Something is tangible and another one is intangible. So tangible means we can touch and feel, we can know. For Italy, for example, Italy, in the cup of tea, it's a, we can touch the cup, but we can't know the ingredients of that tea or the service of the tea or Italy. And the market value, the next one is market value. That market value means is a fixation of price or sold in market. So this is the price that which goods and service are sold in the market, that is the market value. If you product one thing means that is a expansion of or the capital of that product. If you sold means you can get something gain, no? So that is called the market price. The GDP solves this problem by measuring the goods and service in the currency. They are measuring the currency, the value of the product is measuring the currency of the country, the country's currency, which is the rupees in the case of India. So India, we are following the rupee and paisa only. The rupee value are divided from the price at which the goods and service are sold in the market. Only those goods and service with the market value are including GDP. In the olden days, we don't have a money. So that time we use the barter system. So we are exchanging the goods to another goods. So that value is not measuring in the properly. Then later we are introducing the money. That money value, the market value is introducing. And after that only we know the value of the product. And then final goods and service, economist. So the two people, economist, the economist is Taylor Kamen and Alex Talbot Co. He told, so the goods, other goods service, that is, the producting is one good as a finished product. If it is carried out in that, another product means that is not in a finished goods, that is called the semi-finished foods. So for example, the tire. So rubber is a raw material of tire. So tire is a finished product of rubber. But we can't use tire separately. We use to attach the car or any other vehicles. So tire is a semi-product. Tire is a raw material of car or other vehicles. So in this situation, we are measuring the value on the tire in two times. That is called the double counting or intermediate goods. So in between, we are using that ingredients is called the intermediate goods. And in our book, they are giving some other example. One is a tea, cotton, sugar. We take it in tima. So tea is a cup of tea is the rupees of 10. But the ingredients is tea powder, milk, sugar and all. So each is getting one or 2 rupees. So the total value of the tea is 2 rupees. Already the sugar and the milk also already added in the GDP. So again we are adding in the tea also. So this is not a proper GDP. This is called the double counting. And then the national income. So national income is the measures of the total value of goods and service produced by the economic over the product period of a time. And normally, a year commonly, national income is called the gross products. Gross national product are the national divides. So national income is the total value of the nation's income. So domestic product means within the country, within the state. But in the national income means, so we are giving import and exports also is added. And then gross national product, this is the seven divisions is given. And the first one is gross national product, that is GNP. Gross national product is the total value of goods and service and produced and income received a year by domestic residents of a country. It's a domestic income. And it includes its a capital investment to abroad. It also included in the capital to abroad also. That formula, the calculation formula of GNP formula, C plus I plus G plus X minus M plus NFIA. That is C means consumption. We are using, no, that is consumptions. We are the consumers. We are using the product is consumptions. And I means investment. And G means government expenditure. That is tax and GST, land tax and income tax. This and all called the government expenditures. And XMM and minus M means import and export. And net factors income from abroad, that is NFLA means net factors income from abroad. This is the formula of calculation of the gross national product. And gross domestic product, that is GDP, gross domestic product, that GDP is a total value of output of goods and service producing by the factors of production within the geographical boundaries, which in within the country is called the gross domestic product. And net national products, that is NNP, the calculation formula of NNP is GNP minus depreciation. Depreciation means if we using one product means it will be depreciation. In Tamil we are saying in Theimanam. And NNP is arrived by making some adjustment within regarding the depreciations, that is we arrive the net national product by deciding the value of depreciation from gross national product. And then next domestic, net domestic product, the NDP, the net domestic product is a part of the gross domestic product. And net domestic product is obtained from the gross domestic product by the dedications to the year of varying the expansion or the depreciation. The formula is NDP is equal to GDP minus depreciations. And the next one is per capita income. That is short form is PCI. Per capita income of per person is an indicator to show the living standard of people in a country. It is obtained by dividing the national income by the population of country. The formula of the per capita income is per capita income is equal to national income divided by population. This is the formula of calculating the per capita income. And then personal income. Personal income is the total money income received by the individuals and households of the country from all positions sourced before the direct tax. It's a personal income without paying the tax. The household things also, so the small scale industries also is producing the income also, and then household people, wives also is making something, and this income is not for the GDP. This is called the personal income. And disposable income. Disposable income measures actually income which can be spent on the consumption by the individual or the family members. So if it is the disposable income means the family members totally enjoyed or in the individual people are enjoyed. This is called the disposable income. And a gross domestic product GDP. The productions in this country GDP of Indian value only in the market value of goods and service produced in India. So for example, Kashmir, we produce, we get apple from Kashmir, means we sold the apple within the India, within our country. That is called the GDP. If it is in the California, so we get the apple from California, means that is not a, if we sold in India, means that is not taken calculation of GDP, because California is in USA. And next one is proceeding during a time period. I already told you, no, within 1 year we are calculating the economic, that production is called GDP, is called the national income. So that period is dividing into four. So in India they are calculating the yearly ones, otherwise in four quarter periods. These two types we are following. The goods and service produced early periods are not includes. A bicycle product in 2017 will not be included in the measuring on the 2018. So the previous year calculation is not taken to the next year. India measuring in both annual and quarterly. The quarterly is divided into four. The first quarterly, second quarterly, third quarterly and fourth quarterly, are in short form Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 also. And the first one, that is first quarterly, is April, May and June. And second one is July, August, September. And third one is October, November, December. And fourth one is January, February, March. Methods of GDP calculation. In this method, GDP is measured by adding the expenditure on all the final goods and service producing in the country during a specific period. The formula of methods of income, Y is equal to C plus I plus G is equal to X minus M. I already told X minus M means income and expenditure. So this is the method to calculating GDP calculation. The income approach. The earning of the men or women who are involved in the production and the goods and service, or men or women. So that formula is Y is equal to wages plus rent plus interest plus profit. This is the income approach. Value added approach. A cup of tea is a survey. Already we have taken the example of cup of tea. Again we took the same example. And you in the hotel. So the one person is served the cup of tea. So the ingredient of the cup of tea is powder, milk powder, sugar and tea powder also. These are the goods of ingredients. Some of the value added by all the intermediate goods used in product, giving into the total value of the final goods product in the economy. So already we are added the GDP for the sugar, tea powder and milk also. But again we are adding that it's a cup of tea. This is the goods product and the finished product of the GDP. And the importance of GDP. Why we are learning and why we are following this GDPs. So study to economic growth. What are the growthing of Indian's economy? We know about this method. And unequal distribution of wealth. And problems of inflations and deflations, that is ups and downs. And the comparison with the developed countries of the world. We are in growing countries. We are the developing countries. Before the corona, we are developing countries. After that corona, we are the underdeveloped country, going to be underdeveloped. So already, USA is a developed country. Estimate the purchasing power and public sector and guidance of economic plan. So what are the plans we can utilizing for developing the economic growth? So this is the processing of developing the country's economy. And the limitation of the GDP demerits. So the GDP is include only the goods and service sold in the market, the service provided by the parents and their children is very important, but it is not including in the GDP because it is not sold in the market. So only the product or the service only the sold in market, that is only the calculating in GDP. So not calculating the parents' work and also in the children's work, because that is not sold in the market. So that service also including in the market area. And GDP measures only the quantity but not in the quality. So that is the measuring, not measuring in the quality, only in the quantity. So it is in the 1970s, the schools and banks did not permit to use the ballpoint pen. This has become very poor quality. So the government is banned in the 1970s for ballpoint pen. Later the quality has also improved a lot. The improvement is quality of goods is very important, but it is not captured by in the GDP. So the quality is not measuring in GDP. GDP does not tell us about the way income is distributed in the country. The GDP of the country may be growing is rapidly, but income may be in distributions. So unequal that only a small percentage of the people may be benefited from it, because the industrial people are gaining and the workers is a less gaining. And regarding of in the corona period, they are getting a less salaries only, no. So this is the, so few people only gaining much. The GDP does not tell us about the kind of life people are living. So the income only the measuring. The standard of living, the people's standard of living is not measuring. The high level of a percentage real GDP can go hand to hand with the very low health conditions of people. So the product is gaining much because of changing the hand to hand. But in the health conditions of the people is not measuring. And if it is low, means they did not increasing that regarding of GDP. And the composition of the gross domestic product. Indian economics broadly divided into three sectors. One is agriculture, industry and service sector. So this is the three sector for Indian economy is divided. The first one is primary sector, agriculture sector. Agriculture sector is known as a primary sector. Agriculture based allied activities, production of raw materials, so agro based industries, raw materials such as cattle farm, fishing, mining, forestry, coal, etc. are also the undertaken, the agriculture or the primary sector. And then second one is secondary sector or industrial sectors. Goods and commodities are produced by transforming raw materials, for example, iron and steel, cotton textile, jute, sugar, cement, paper, automobile and other small scale industries are under the control of secondary sector or industrial sector. And the third one is territory sector or the service sector. It includes government scientific research, transport, communication, trade, postal and telegram, banking, education, healthcare and information technology, etc. Only the giving service, not producing anything. This is called the service sector. India is the second larger producer of agriculture product. And industrial sector in India would be the rank of 6. And the service sector, India is a rank of 8. Economic growth and development. As per the economist, so Amitra Sen, already we learned is a 2 economics already, and this is the 3rd economics. Amitra Sen, economic growth is one of, as per the economic development also, so limited nation see in the like this economic development factors not only on the men's materialistic need, but its focus on overall development or rise in its living standard. So economics, Amritsar Sen told, so don't mention, so not only mentioning the economic product and also mentioning the men and material, the human being, already we saw, you know, so women and children, parents also giving the GDP, that measures is not taken in the national income. So the Amritsar Sen told, he is a famous as economics, he told, so we want to calculate the men and women and then standard of living also. development path based on the GDP and employment. In the development path, if it is making a national income, calculating the national income means, so we get undertook the policy of closing trade in the year is 1977. So we are closing the abroad trades and all. This was giving the trust of the domestic product and reduce the depends on the foreign product and companies. So in 1917, before 1917, we stopped the free, we stopped the free trade for other foreign countries' goods and all, we stopped. That is very helped to survey the domestic products. India opened its abroad for to free trade and liberated in economic by the allowing the foreign companies to enter in the Indian economy. This is the very trust for giving the employment generation under the 5-year plan. Per capita incomes have doubled in 12 years. So within 12 years, the per capita income is double. India has followed the different path of development for many other countries. India went more quickly for agriculture to survey. GDP growth of India. India's economic growth story since in the 1990s has been stable, reflected strong microeconomics fundamentals. Goods and service tax, that is GST, the World Bank project, a growth rate of 7.3 in the year 2018-19 and 7.5 in the year 2019-20. GDP growth rate in India in 2018 is project at 7.3 and in India is a fifth fastest growing nation of the world, just behind Bangladesh. Thank you, students.